Number 15, Ar-Rida removes from you miserliness. Being in a state of rida and content, it helps cultivate, it helps remove from your heart miserliness and chasing of dunya, right? And also regrets when giving. You know, some people, subhanAllah, they give and then they mope about it. They regret it. They say, oh, shaitan comes. Shaitan and the nafs. Well, you know, why did you go and say you're going to give that money to them? You could have, kept it. You yourself are in need, subhanAllah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he'd have one date, and, Abu Huraira would ask for food, because Abu Huraira was poor, Rasul would, كَنَا يُشُقَّ تَمْرَ, he would split it in half and give that half to Abu Huraira. Regret over khair removes the barakah of it, and you remove the reward from yourself. You see, the nafs of the human being is miserly. The nafs clings. The nafs, it's not a generous nafs. So a lot of people, many people, subhanAllah, when they do volunteer, they do sadaqah, the charity with their time, charity with their, because you see. And this miserliness and this regrets comes from not being content. If the person truly had rida, and Allah's choices, rida that Allah is always gonna give, rida that inshallah Allah is there, that trust, they wouldn't have these regrets. But it's because their heart is empty of rida, they sit and stew over what they've done, khair for other people, and get bitter over it. Wa a'udhu billah. Number 16, shaitan overcomes the human being in two cases. The shaitan really jumps on your back in two cases. One, when you are resentful, because we said rida removes resentfulness, right? And the second time the ulama says is during lust. Whenever you're in a state of shahwa, shaitan yathfur bi ibn Adam عند السخط وعند الشهوة. These are when you're at your weakest, when you're in a state of resentfulness, you're upset. You're upset at something. Shaitan he jumps. And when you're overcome by lust for something, it doesn't matter what that shahwa, it might be shahwa of spending money on something, shahwa of it's whatever, you're in a state of lustfulness, baser, tapping in those baser desires, that's when you're most weak. That's when the shaitan hits. When you're upset, and subhanAllah, that's when the true colors come out, when you're upset. Yes, and that's when the true colors of something come out. Ask someone what they think of you, that when you're upset, that's when what you truly think of Allah comes out. When you're resentful, when you're upset, when something hits you, what you're saying and how you behave, it shows you what you think of Allah. And in a state of shahwa, because when someone is overcome with desire for something or desire, it blinds them. They can't think. And again, Allah, whoop, out of your heart. Ask someone, and this is just, let's contextualize it now in dunya, in our own environments. Ask someone what they think of you when you've angered them major. Ask them, and they'll tell you what honestly they think of you. But ask someone what they think of you when you've given them gifts and presents. It's like it's the same. May Allah be above comparison. But when Allah gives, oh, alhamdulillah, Allah is beautiful. Allah is good. God is good. Yani Allah isn't good out of when He doesn't give you. Subhanallah. But this is our reality. This is our truth. And we need to look in the mirror. Number 16, true rida is to choose, true rida is to choose what Allah has chosen for you. That's true rida. And resentfulness is to hate what Allah has chosen for you. When I ask you, subhanAllah, when I ask somebody, if you were to choose something, what would you choose? If you were to choose something, what would people try to practice piety and they say, well, inshallah, I choose whatever Allah wills, whatever Allah wants. Allah, okay, If this is the truly the case that's in your heart, Allah, this is Allah has Allah. This is what Allah's chosen for you. Then why are you upset? You see, we don't listen to ourselves when we say Alhamdulillah. I just want what Allah wants. But do you truly mean that? Have you realized this meaning in your heart? Because if you have, then why are you upset when it does when something else, when He chooses something else? You know, there's an interesting story. And my sheikh said this, had said this to us. There were two people, you know, they were in a desert. There was no food, nothing. They were walking, two friends. And they had only two pieces of bread. There was one big loaf, and one that was a quarter of a loaf, a little one. So, you know, they stopped to eat. And they said, okay, which, you know, each friend, the friend was saying, no, to the other friend. You choose whatever it is you're going to take, whatever it is you want. So that friend was trying to tell him, no, you choose whatever bread, you know, I'll eat whatever is left. So the friend chose the big piece. So the other friend that said that was taken aback. He's like, طيب يعني, you should have had a little bit of a humbleness and practiced some being unselfish, and you should have chosen something else. So the friend that chose the big piece of bread asked his friend, okay, if it was you, what would you have chosen? The friend said, I would have chosen the little one. And then the friend's like, well, there it is. Why are you complaining? So this is what Allah is saying. And if you're saying, I'll choose what Allah chooses. Well, there it is. Allah has chosen for you. Why are you upset? It's the same story with the loaves of bread. Yani, you're telling me I would have chosen the little one. Well, there it is. And why are you complaining? It's right there in front of you. Eat it. You see, we don't take a good look at ourselves. This is the problem.